This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Good yawning this morning, and welcome back to Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, your station for fresh news, smart talk all day. It is Wednesday, the 25th of January, 2023, and you are on the clock with Erin Greene and the Guardian Radio AM Man Down Mashup Wednesday. Now, it's going to be a little different today. We have special guests in studio for the first hour. Mr. Ian Munnings on my left and Mr. Cecil Newry on my right don't know that I have brought two of the most powerful, prolific artists in the Bahamas to join me today for Man Down Wednesday. Y'all thought I was going to let y'all have me in this room with y'all by myself. The balance is uneven. Two man to one woman, but I have some backup today, gentlemen. And joining me this morning are Ms. Sonia Farmer and Ms. Helen Clenaris. Two Bahamian writers and artists. I call them Renaissance women. Their practice moves from writing poetry to art to music to what I like to call assemblage, right? Where they put things together, not just like a montage of images, of digital images, not just a collection of poetry, but they put together like people and energy and spirit. Right? And they create a space where people can realize their best selves. And, you know, like my friend Stelitze, the Bahamas is big thing because we got people like Sonia Farmer and Helen Clenaris in it. Now, gentlemen, y'all don't be afraid now. Us women, we ain't coming here to tear down the place. Not today. Maybe in the second hour. Not today. Good morning, Mr. Newry.
It's always good to be on your show, Erin. Thank you very much for the invite. I am excited, actually, about this interview. You know when you humble yourself in front of great people?
Yeah.
They actually have me blushing. And you know it's hard for me to blush because, you know, I'm blue-black.
Yeah, yeah.
And so my entire face right now is purplish.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? And I'm kind of excited about the conversation to have. Yeah. I'm trying to steal them from you because
yeah, yeah.
I have one or two interviews I like to have with them. So I'm begging you, can you allow them to come?
Absolutely. On? I need to let you know that I am honored to be here because you yourself.
What happened to me?
Is poet.
Yeah, yeah.
Who's right things.
Few people know I write things. So.
Yeah. I know. I know they don't know.
But I may have to consider taking up Helen and Sonia class because they professional, you know, they like lecturers and teachers on how to do things properly.
Absolutely.
So, yeah.
In fact, so this morning we're going to be talking about Ponciana Paper Press.
Yes.
Right? And that is a center for writing, book arts, publishing projects in Nassau, the Bahamas. And I'm very excited about book arts. I have a thing about books.
You know you have to explain all that to me, right?
Yeah, well, I don't know what book arts is, but I have a thing about books.
Books.
And I just like books.
Yeah.
I like them to be around me.
You like to read.
I didn't say I like to read.
You didn't say you like to read?
I didn't say that. I mean, I like to read, but I didn't say that.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is I like to have them around me. I like them to be in my bedroom. They could be on the bed with me.
They make you look smart?
They make me feel smart most of all. I don't know if they make me look smart. They make me feel smart. Oh. Sometimes I feel like if I just go to sleep in the room with a new book, that some of the knowledge in the new book.
Assimilation.
Yeah, just soak
its
way. Osmosis.
Ah.
Right? And I think every child should like have that experience, right? Mm. Like you just have books. Let me tell you what it is.
Mm-hmm.
You grow up, I'm 46,
mm-hmm.
born 1976.
Yes.
Right? You grow up in that era. ZNS ain't your friend, buddy.
No.
Even when they on, they ain't on.
Yeah.
But to be in a space where you sit back and you realize, well, if the power don't come on,
mm-hmm.
I got 807 books here to turn to. Like, if I get tired in the first paragraph of this book, I got another book I could just go and read the first paragraph.
Look at
like,
you.
Children need that experience that I could be all right. If there's no power, there's none of these things, I could fall into a book or seven. Mm. Or 14.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a power in that. And all children need to experience that. That's why libraries are important.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Because a child can't purchase all of those books. Every parent, look here, their parents. I mean, the law doesn't support you, but sell the book if you have to pay for electricity.
Nice.
Right? If I saw my child trying to amass a library
mm-hmm.
and things is tough, I'd look at the child and say, baby, I love you. I don't know how you get this textbook, but we selling this.
I sell everything after
265.
When the school year finished, anyway, thing is
so. Right? So libraries are super important to crafting the space where children can imagine
mm-hmm.
and build worlds beyond anything they've ever seen or felt or thought about, right? And that's why libraries and books are so important, because the first thing you do when you look at a book is you imagine what's inside it. And then the journey begins, right? And then the journey begins. And so I have today two mm-hmm. bookmasters, two wordsmiths joining us. Now, I say all of that to say this. I need to say this, Cecil, because this show may run forever. I went to McDonald's this morning, and I will say this. This morning's experience at McDonald's was much faster than my previous experiences, but I feel the need to remind fast food staff, y'all are still performing better than the government. That's all I want to tell y'all. Y'all still performing better than the government. See in my
good morning, Bahamas. This is gonna be Master Wednesday.
All right, we can get into that in the second half. In the second half,
let's talk books.
Yeah, let's talk books. So, Miss Sonia Farmer is the. Now, Miss Farmer gave me her own bio. I don't know why these people like to give me their own bio. You're gonna correct me. I'm not gonna read from that right now. Sonia Farmer is the founder of Poinciana Paper Press. It was founded in 2009.
Mm-hmm.
Poinciana Paper Press works with writers and artists using multiple forms of publishing to advance the diversity of narratives in Caribbean literature. So I like that. You can't just capture the story of the Chickchani on one page, like a page of a book. You need various forms of publishing to capture that.
Correct.
I love that. Her artwork has been exhibited internationally, regionally in the Caribbean, and locally in the Bahamas, including NAGB and the Central Bank of the Bahamas Art Gallery, where her piece, Alekia Tings, received an honorable mention in their 32nd annual art competition and exhibition. She's an Obermann Fellow of the Graduate Institute for Engagement and Academy.
What?
Mm-hmm.
So she's people. She's real people.
I mean, A, she's real people. B, like, I didn't realize I was going to be 46 and have a real role model. Like, that's what I want to do. Dear Bahamas, dear University of the Bahamas, COB, it took me a very long time to figure out what course I wanted to take.
Mm-hmm.
But this is it right here. Institute for Engagement and the Academy.
That's right, yeah.
That is the most powerful space in the Academy right now, I imagine.
It was really amazing.
Ms. Farmer, tell us about yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, Erin, thank you so much again for having me on, and Helen as well. We're really excited to chat about Poinciana Paper Press. So, like you said, I'm the founding director now of Poinciana Paper Press, which mm-hmm. started off as a publishing, I don't want to say company, but just a book publisher. But it's turned into now I have a center, like a community center. So now it's a center for writing book arts and publishing. Me, myself. I know you're asking about me. So I am a writer.
Mm-hmm.
I am a book artist and book designer. And I, I like to make books.
Yeah.
I'm primarily a poet, but I write in multiple mediums. In fact, I have to be back at The Guardian, where I used to write for the arts and culture section here. But these days, my brain doesn't deal so much with...
news.
Yeah, with news, man, it's rough. But I process things more through poetry and creative writing. But I also make books. So that means that I enjoy making books of other people's writing as well as my own writing. And I self-publish my work as limited edition poetry collections, but also as very limited edition handmade artist books. Yeah. So that, you know, earlier... Cecil, you asked about what are book arts.
I'm going to ask what a book art is.
So book arts is anything to do with the allied crafts of the book. So this is really like very Luddite crafts here. So writing for sure is one of them, but also book binding. So making books by hand. Mm-hmm. So I know how to make books by hand, sew books, use different binding structures to make them. Letterpress printing, which is a form of movable type old-fashioned printing, right? Gutenberg days kind of printing, so I do that as well. Printmaking methods, so block printing, silkscreen printing, as well as handmade paper. So I'm also a hand paper maker.
Nice.
In addition, we also have calligraphy at the space. I also dabble in calligraphy, but luckily I work with a professional calligrapher, Leanne Key of the Nassau Script Company. So she teaches calligraphy classes at the press. Nice. Yeah.
Who knew this happens in the Bahamas?
Right.
I'm blown away already.
Wonderful. Yeah. Well, we've only been open for 6 months, technically. So we're expanding our programming.
You say that, Helen, I'm coming to you right now. See, so you jump in. You say you've only been open for 6 months, right? But then I read about in April 2019, you presented for your thesis exhibition, Ponciana Paper Press, a publishing model for the Caribbean. So this has been an idea that you've been imagining and growing for a while now.
Yeah, I've been very, very committed to kind of building platforms for us to self-publish and really express ourselves through the form of the book here within the Caribbean. I mean, there are a lot of publishers also in the Caribbean. There are really famous publishers outside of the Caribbean that work with Caribbean writers and elevate them. But I'm really interested in what happens when we can kind of create like a community space around a small press, Ponciana Paper Press, within this center to really like express ourselves, because the thing about it is the story of the Caribbean, right, has always privileged the voice of the visitor and the viewpoint of the visitor. And I'm really interested in like what happens when we can like foster cultural ownership over our own lived experiences and how powerful that can be for us to really frame who we are.
Yeah.
And we can do that through the book.
And you mentioned the word community space, right? Does that mean I can come to your place and experience it? Like
yes.
A field trip to understand exactly what you do?
Absolutely. So
and there are things for me to engage in?
Yes. So at Ponciana Paper Press, we're now located at number 12 Parkgate Road. We do have shifting hours, as I'm the only person really at Ponciana Paper. I'm founding director, I'm studio manager, I'm accountant, I'm a communications officer. But for the most part, I am there during like regular working hours and sometimes into the evening, especially when we have classes. And right now, it's a primarily like an educational space as well as a shared studio. So we do have a couple of artists who come in and make work there. So Margot Bethel is one of them. She makes her silkscreen work. I have one of her shirts here for you to look at. It's a little saucy. I don't know if I can talk about it on air, but she makes some brilliant, brilliant shirts with like Bahamian.
Suggestive wording,
yeah, Bahamian language, things like that. And so she works there quite a bit. But mostly we offer classes, and most of our classes are launching in February.
I see you have cards here and
I have a little shop as well.
Say I have an idea of printing something on a shirt or I have an idea to make my own Valentine's Day card, right? Can I come to your space and say, man, this is what I'm thinking of? Do you have a program that I can do that?
Hold on, wait. I could make customized Galentine's Day cards for all my sweethearts.
Yes.
I mean, not actual
sweethearts. How many sweethearts you have?
You don't mind that. I have, they sweet. I mean, they diabetic.
You say you're getting yourself they're a
diabetic.
Problem?
That's
you're
all I can tell you.
Problems. Let's go back.
I have a, well, yes, because for example, if you wanted to do that, you could take our Make Your Own Valentine's Day Cards class, which is on Sunday, February 12th. It's a 4-hour class. So you'll marble your own paper, and then you will carve a design and print it on top of the marbled paper.
So the wife and I can come there on Saturday and do our own cards.
It's, yeah, on the Sunday, on the 12th.
On the Sunday.
Yeah. But I also do private sessions. So whatever classes you see online, and you're like, wow, I really want to take this sip and bind class where we make our own hardcover notebook wrapped in Androsia or Bahama handprints fabric, like I brought one with here with me today for you to take a look at.
Nice.
So if you know, if you're like, wow, I really want to take that, but I can't come on that day, or I want to do it for my friend who's visiting, or a special group, I do groups of 3 to 8 people, private session for these classes, and it's generally the same amount, and it includes wine.
Cecil, I'm going to bring them all together one time, and we're going to make our cards together.
Nice.
That's how you bring balance in the community.
That's how you bring. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. I don't mind if you just go buy out my class today. That's super cool. So no one's registered yet.
Sunday, February 12th.
That's
and
correct.
And before we leave, we're going to share all of the registration information for the classes that you're offering.
Absolutely.
I want to say in this season. But what do you have planned for the year? And before that, who have you collaborated with? You have artists that work in studio.
Mm-hmm.
Is this a collaborative space as well? Who have you collaborated with? And what's the scope of collaboration? Like, what could I come and ask you to entertain?
Sure. So the space is a very collaborative space, right? Mm-hmm. I'm very interested. I mean, I think the book is the perfect collaborative space, like, to have. Like, a book is such a dynamic site of performance, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And printmaking and everything is, you know, community print shops always have community at the heart of them.
Yeah.
Right now I collaborate mostly through my classes, like with my students, and also with the people who are also teaching. So like I said, Leanne Key is teaching calligraphy classes, and then Margot Bethel is teaching silkscreen printing classes where you can print your own design on your t-shirts and tote bags.
Mm-hmm.
And then Helen, who's here, is teaching some writing classes coming up for the whole year. We have a whole year planned, so I'm sure she'll tell you about that. Then we have another writer coming on for the first time in February. She's going to be doing a writing little love notes, so you can write love letters for Valentine's Day or shortly thereafter.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm really interested in the space. I'm interested in collaborating with other people to make it an educational space. I'm hoping more and more that people can teach these crafts of writing, publishing, and book arts, so the allied crafts of the book. But also, in terms of my artistic practice, I enjoy collaborating with folks. I really like making books of other people's writing. My writing, too, but other people's writing. And sometimes what happens is I'll read a poem, and then suddenly I'll see the book, and I'll ask permission, and I'll make it. So I'm hoping to provide lots of opportunities like that this year to publish again. I am looking at a manuscript right now to get ready for the year, as well as do some other programming, like maybe bring back Story Slam or a broadside reading series or something. Mm-hmm. So if you keep up with us online, you'll see what comes up.
Just the last thing, Cecil, the name of the school on Kemp Road, the government primary school, that's Stephen Dillard, right?
No,
that's what that one is. The one with no windows.
Uriah
McPhee, right. This is dear corporate sponsors. I'm going to need you all to go to Pontiana Paper Press and sit down with Miss Sonia Farmer, and let's talk about a possible partnership, right? Where we work with the students at Uriah McPhee and allow them to create a story, right? And then go to Pontiana Paper Press, right? That's right in their community,
and
get it published. Now, I'm thinking, first of all, let the children write whatever they want because it's their story.
Mm-hmm.
But
that's
it would be a great opportunity for a bit of sort of grief counseling and grief therapy if those kids who have been affected by gun violence and violence and violence generally in the community.
You're always thinking.
Would have a space to see.
No, Erin, this is, it's true. I'm highly, highly interested in outreach opportunities like that, like especially to support literacy as well, because I think like the work that I do in making books like operates at like this level, you know, up here, but we can't, you know, get people to appreciate books and reading if we can't do something like at the root, you know?
Nice.
And so making your own books is an extremely empowering process. So to have like, I've done a few free zine classes where folks have come and they've just been blown away. They're like, this is so fun. I never thought I could make something like this. Thank you for having this space. It's important for adults too. It's like adult craft time. We need time to be creative and we don't give ourselves that permission. So if it's that powerful for adults, it's even more powerful for kids.
And it shows the importance and need of different types of publishing of literature. We see literature differently. We engage literature differently. Right. And we produce literature differently.
Because we're an active part of it. And this goes back to what I said about having our story being told by other people instead of like our own authentic lived narratives. And not the narratives we think other people want to hear.
Yes.
Yeah. Our real real selves and stories. Here,
what attention, Cecil. I need you to have me on that show as a guest.
Yes.
When we talk about that, right? The tension between the stories you want to tell of yourself and the stories that people want to hear and want to tell about you. Mm-hmm. But we got to make a shift.
Yes.
Over to the other side of the table.
Yeah.
Good morning, Ms. Glenaris. How are you doing?
Good morning. I'm great. I'm great. It's good to be here.
Absolutely. You're waking again in the Bahamas.
I am. You know, I tell people love brought me home. Yeah. And it's, you know, when you're away from home for 17 years, you really feel the absence. Mm-hmm. And my whole entire nervous system has completely calmed down by being back. So, mm-hmm.
And how important is it for you to be offering these first two classes in the year's schedule of classes, the first being writing the fantastic, an introduction, and then the second, crafting wonder.
Yeah.
How important is it to like sort of be home and offer these workshops?
There's so many things that are going through my mind, having just listened to what Sonia said, you know, about being able to write your own narratives, not the ones that people want to hear. But the ones that live inside you and that need to come out, that express who you are, that define who you are, that give you space to get to know yourself. So it's very important. These classes that have come through, I began scheming and dreaming about them, last year. They're extremely important. They're my dream. It's the dream class that I've always wanted to teach, right? Mm-hmm. Bringing together mythology and fairy tales and folk tales and literature and storytelling. And it's the kind of class that has brought together all of my loves, all the things that I'm most passionate about, including justice, mm-hmm. right? How do we write a story that will create justice in our own lives and in the world around us, mm-hmm. right? When there's so many things, excuse me, that ail us, mm-hmm. right? I read once that a true myth shows us what ails us in our culture and how to cure it, mm-hmm. right? That's what a true myth does, and fairy tales as well, right? And so writing the fantastic is also about that. It's about what ails me as an individual, what ails us as a society, and how can I bring my imagination to that place and imagine something that could make us better, imagine something that can tell a new story that we can live.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that Absolutely. Doesn't just entertain us, but that shows us a new way to live.
Absolutely. So Writing the Fantastic is a 5-week workshop.
Yeah.
Led by yourself.
Yes.
Exploring myth, folk, and fairy tales to bring the transformative and transcendent to your writing. Fantasy and literature reveals the unsayable, defies the impossible, and expands what we have been told reality is. Is this not the thing that we need?
And Helen, I'm very interested in this, right?
Amen.
Because I took upon myself recently saying there's a need for us to tell tales about Bohemian mythology.
Yes.
Like, few people know that we have a monster called the Lusca.
Right.
In the Bohemian waters, supposedly, right?
Right.
It has been like a 300-year-old story.
Yes.
Few people understand what is a Chicchani.
That's right.
And what is the story, the origin of it, right?
Yes.
The Golem.
Yes.
You know, the damn fool who married them. But no one knows what is a yak. The mermaid, right?
That's real.
The mermaid is real.
Listen, I guess I have to tell you all the Chicchani origin story again. I will do soon.
But I mean, no, you have Chicchanis in your backyard, right?
Yeah,
but no one knows what even a Yahoo is, and that Abaco women would have been kidnapped by Yahoos, right? These stories need to be rebirthed and retold with a Bohemian narrative.
That's
and the
right.
idea that you are taking advantage of this and leading this charge, you say, okay, let me help you with this, guide this, to bring this thing back to life. I'm impressed with that.
Mm-hmm. That's beautiful. You know, it's difficult to say where these stories come from. Are they real? Mm-hmm. Are they, you know, was there a 6-foot owl that came into
pardon? The Merking saw him, so the Merking would know.
That's right. Yes. But what I want to say is whether they are fable or truth, they live in our unconscious for a reason. Mm. We need those images. We need those symbols. They do something for us. They expand, our psyches. They give us a lifeline in some way to connect to the ocean, to the bush, to the, you know, and to the unconscious within us, where something is trying to say something to us. And so, you know, they tell us that myths are the dreams of cultures. Right? In the same way that a dream is a myth for each of us individually, right? And so that's very exciting. That's what I want to tap into in this class is, you know, what lives in the murky depths of our own unconscious, and how does that connect us to one another? How does that connect us to our history?
I wanted to know, what should I expect when I come to this class for this mythology type thing you're going to be doing?
Okay, so each class builds on the last, right? And so each class, the first class, we look at myth and the connection of our unconscious to myths. The second class, we look at folk tales, right? We bring in stories about the Chicchani and about the Luska, and also, you know, we reach out to other parts of the Caribbean and look at their myths and their folk tales as well. We look at folk tales from other parts of the world, and then each class, I give you prompts, I give you assignments to write based on a folk tale that interests you, based on a myth that interests you. Third class, we look at fairy tales, you know, and we look at what does it do for us to take a fairy tale we're aware of and rewrite it. You know, the very common story of Cinderella. What does that look like in Bahamian terms? Mm-hmm. How might we rewrite that to meet our own interests and imaginations and needs? So that's what we do each class.
And it's so important because people, you know, while people are telling me, oh, this Chicchani story ain't real, and I telling them, listen, I on my third edit.
Yeah.
Wonderful. So my great grandfather would have from Fresh Creek.
Yeah.
Chicchani Hotel, Boyd's and the Gays.
Wow,
right? He would have, as far as I'm concerned, I should have brought my BJC project. I think I got a B on it, so it must be right. He would have been the first person to write in the international media about the Chicchani, right?
Wow,
I think it was published in Ebony.
I'd love to read that.
And possibly Jed as well, right? So I feel no weight retelling the Chicchani story, claiming it as my own. Like I am the herald of that story, and I have a responsibility to not just tell it, to preserve it, but also to allow it to evolve at the same time.
Right.
I see we have a call-up. Your people don't get to be the first person to do the Chicchani story.
Listen.
And Chamberlain, the Prime Minister of Britain, got cursed by a Chicchani. It's written in our history.
Yeah, well, I mean, okay. Just because we write about them and sell them don't mean we could control them.
There you go.
You got to understand the game.
I understand.
Absolutely. Only the Merking could... Anyway, see, y'all don't believe in these things. Let's carry on. See, I know you have plenty of questions. Are the workshops face-to-face, or can I participate if I'm not in country?
They're both. Yeah. So we have an online version of the class via Zoom, and we also are doing it in person at Ponciana Paper Press.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Let's just take a moment, go to the caller, and we get back to these sort of technical questions, the things we need to know to participate. Good morning, caller. Good morning. How are you?
All right. The screen because you always tell me what's sparky and all these stories, right?
Yeah.
And all these histories, right?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll be trying to drill something into you. You'll be bringing in a lot. You'll be bringing all your shows, a lot of very intelligent people who are doing the writing and everything.
Yeah.
But I'll be trying to drill into you sometimes. There's some people out there you're not getting to. That has the actual stories. Some names of people that can enhance your show. And certainly you wanted me away sometimes. There's some people that's great.
Tell me the names right now, Sparky.
You're not contacted.
Sparky, tell me the names right now.
Okay, I can tell you people like Rosie Cadet in the Valley.
Okay.
People like Cleese O'Mullins and those. People, like I said, the Eddie 4s.
Hold on, you may say it slow enough for me to write it down, Sparky?
Yeah, okay, hold on.
Say it again.
These people have lived the stories, but they don't do the writing. See, you're bringing the writers in.
I need to connect them now to the stories.
The writers, the stories. The people who know the real stories, who lived it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I want to meet them.
you hear Sparky telling you these history sometimes? And then you just be cutting Sparky off.
Sparky, give me the name.
Then people come back and they say, Sparky, where you get this information? A lot of this stuff I lived.
Sparky, give me the names.
I gave you the... You got to be... Get these people before they die. Please.
Yes, Sparky. But you make a good husband, Sparky.
You got to miss the Rosie Cadet.
Yeah.
You got to miss the Cleso Money.
Cleco?
Cleso. C-L-E-S-O.
Cleso, okay, because you know...
These people who could talk the story, but they maybe can't write it.
I understand.
And you got people like Mr. Eddie Ford, a behavior sports. Like, you like sports.
Yeah.
He's also a fellow that went off to play professional.
That's Mario Ford, daddy?
That's Mario Ford, brother.
That's his brother, okay.
That's Mario Ford, brother.
I got you, Spock.
He played basketball, cricket, baseball. He went off on baseball, the baseball camp too, you know.
Okay.
Not only Mario Ford.
I got you.
These fellas lived the migration from the Western Port to Cleveland to the Sports Center. They can tell you what. See, all the people like Timmy Barron just died the other day.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Condolences.
God bless the dead and that Mark Dumpton's family. The stories that these athletes that you all never interview, they died.
Sparky, look here. Thank you. Thank you, Sparky. I got you. Mm-hmm. Sparky make a good husband. He know how to keep a secret?
Yes. What?
Oh, he know how to keep a secret, eh?
I mean, he brings up a good point, which is that, you know, our oral people who are the holders of our oral histories are indeed, we're losing them.
Mm-hmm.
And oral history, I mean, first of all, being such a huge part of Bahamian culture,
mm-hmm.
It's just a huge part of understanding who we are in general. That is also something that the press is going to engage in. I'm one person with zero grants, so we'll get there.
Absolutely.
But I'm hoping to build some projects that can support oral histories. You
don't
know.
Watch nothing.
Also the original, this is like mythology, just ties right into what Helen is talking about. Like all of our stories begin as oral tales.
That's right.
You know, writing came in later. And I think something that's part of this discussion is that the book is a colonial object that was used for oppression. And that's why I am interested in using the book to see what we can do to engage in that history. Right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I was looking at... In your bio, you won the Holly Award for Excellence in Book Arts for
A
True and Exact History. And it's just fascinating, right? The book and its use to oppress.
Right. That was a formative book in Caribbean history, really about the island of Barbados.
Mm-hmm.
But it could be kind of applied to how a history of the Caribbean is treated like across the region.
Mm-hmm.
So I did an erasure of that text, which means that I removed a portion of most of the words to create new voices coming out of the text to tell tales from the margins.
Beautiful.
Through our history. Yeah, because it brings into question, like, who is allowed to write about the history of a space? Of course, it's written by a white man. What does it mean to even write a true and exact history of anything?
Yeah.
You know? What is impressive is that you sound like griots, people who record history through the book, and that is a need and a mandate for you, like yourself, you know, when you feel building up inside you, that you need to write to record what is happening. And that is impressive, too. Especially from a Bahamian perspective.
Yeah, because, sorry, I just one last thing that was brought up for me through Sparky's comment is that I also just want to say, like, stories belong to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think we also need to kind of resist this narrative that only certain people have a story to tell. Like, we all have a collective story to tell, which brings us to a collective understanding about the human experience or a subject. So I also just want to put that forward, like, that is really important, too, to remember.
Absolutely. And I taught this class, you know, last year in
that's right.
When was
November.
That? November. And I think what was the most exciting thing about it was all the stories that people were telling.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the writers in the group were telling extraordinary stories. And I could see them becoming, you know, animations and films and, you know, books and other kinds of art. And in fact, it inspired me to think about ways that we could share their work in a multimedia kind of setting.
Absolutely. So what are the dates for the courses?
So they begin. These are for Helen's courses. Mm-hmm. So she has two sections of writing the fantastic, mm-hmm. and they're both 5-week courses that go from 6 to 8 p.m. So they start either Monday, February 6th, for 5 weeks.
And that's mm-hmm. the online, yeah.
That's the online version, 6 to 8 p.m.
That's
or
February.
That's mm-hmm. February 6th. Or Tuesday, February 7th, again, 6 to 8 p.m., and that's in person at Poinciana Paper Press. We have a lovely library that you can sit in and take this class with Helen. It's very fun. Online is available, too, because it's for whoever might want to take it, especially if folks are listening from the diaspora.
Yeah.
Please,
right.
please take a class with us.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
And the dates for Crafting Wonder, the second workshop?
Crafting Wonder, we are going to have starting February 8th.
Yes.
Exactly. And that is online only. And that is a 6-week course.
That's right. And,
yes.
And that's for folks who already have something that they're working on that they'd like help with.
Okay.
That you know, particularly in the area of the fantastic, right? How do you write magical realism? How is it different than mm-hmm. realism? Right?
So whereas writing the fantastic is more of an introductory course,
yeah.
Crafting Wonder is for folks who probably already have a completed first draft of a manuscript and are ready to get like down serious into
yeah.
the craft of mm. how to like bring out the fantastic even more.
Please, Lisa, I'm only going to talk about how I won't go there.
This is my next question. Say I'm writing something now, an
yes.
anthology for poetry, or just even have my own manuscript.
Yes.
Having some issues, you know, editorial or some direction. I stuck. Writer's block, right? Can I come to you all and get help?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, you know, Crafting Wonder is specifically for folks who are writing in the genre of fantasy, but folks who are interested in other kinds of writing, you know, just let us know.
We'll do consultancy
yeah,
type thing.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
okay.
Yes, absolutely. One-on-one, but also creating workshops for those who are already in the thick of
yeah.
writing and need
help.
Some support.
And
yeah.
And what
workshop,
publishing? Go ahead.
Sorry, I just want to say, too, that like don't sleep on the workshop space, though. You know, mm-hmm. like it is good to get one-on-one, and you do get that through the class with Helen. Helen is mm-hmm. a brilliant mm-hmm. teacher. I've taken classes with her,
mm-hmm.
and
Thank
she's brought
you.
Out the fantastic in my work. Many years ago now, but I continue to return to that piece and work on it and think about it. But the workshop space is so critical because you also get encouraged and shaped by your peers.
Mm.
And so it's not just that you get encouraged and shaped by Helen,
That's
but
right.
you also get to help. You get to see what your peers are writing. You get to help them bring their story out. And in turn, they help you. It's a beautiful, like, collaborative space, the space of the workshop. So the class also offers that.
Isn't
it's a dedicated cohort.
Mm-hmm. I mean, do you have like a large persons coming in attending your classes?
We added more spots for the online class,
That's
didn't
right.
we?
That's right.
The
we
in-person
did.
Class only had 3 students, which is still a great size for
yes.
a cohort.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But the online class, I think, had 7.
8.
8,
yeah.
wow.
Yeah,
yeah. We were
yeah.
going to just have 6, so
yeah.
we added more seats.
Yeah.
How do we register, and do I need any resources? Like, if I'm doing the online class, is there a type of software that I should have? Do I need a special pen? Like, here, bring your pen, your specialist one.
Whatever pen you want to write with, pencil is fine. Crayon is good, too. Whatever really inspires you.
Can I bring my inspiration? Because, listen, Cecil, I'm waking on. Look here, I realize that the ghost move is both mythical and policy, right? I want to write about the ghost move. It's fantastic. Fantastical.
It is.
What some of these people be telling their partners, but where they be going. And I don't know if y'all should be
Look
offering this course
gone.
Because Bahamians are already too creative.
We are natural storytellers.
Fantastic.
Yes. We are.
This place is magical.
Yeah.
And I don't mean magical through the tourism lens of, you know, whatever one-dimensional way we understand magical to be, which doesn't even apply to people. That's really landscape when they're talking about it. Like, the Bahamas is magical in that raw
yeah.
way. You know, that we have all of these mythologies, and Bahamians mm-hmm. are natural storytellers. This
mm-hmm.
is why we had the Story Slam. Poinciana Paper Press was doing that for a couple of years with Orchid
Improv
Burnside.
Storytelling.
Yes. And we had a Story Slam for the first 2 months of 2020. And then the pandemic happened.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm hoping to bring it back. But we also did that through 2015 as well, and it was excellent.
A quick question for Helen.
You know,
yes, absolutely.
Are ghosts part of myths?
Absolutely.
I know some people who write some ghost stories. I want to know
yes.
if they could come to this class.
Oh, yes, definitely.
Okay.
Big part.
Okay, good. I just need to know that. Yes. Just need to know that.
Yes. You know why they call it a ghost move, right?
Go ahead.
Because that wasn't me. You saw it as a ghost.
That was a ghost.
That wasn't me. That was a ghost.
Uh-huh.
Good morning to Avi.
Mm-hmm.
And D-Mac.
Mm-hmm.
And Stilete.
Mm-hmm.
And Johnny Cake. And who else? Gino D is a storyteller, you know.
Yeah.
I did forget that.
Remember the junglist?
Junglist, yes.
Yeah. And the rose dig up.
Yeah. Such imagery. Yeah. I mean, we really do a whole cadre of artists are creatives. This is wonderful. Okay, so tell us again the dates, how to register, how much the courses cost.
Mm-hmm.
Will there be... Listen.
And the landing page, because I don't know if they go from here, if I could ever find them again.
Yeah, how do we contact you?
Do I call Erin? Erin, who do people know?
I also want to say that every class ends with a reading that you can invite everybody to. Whether it's online or we actually did it online. People invited their nieces, their nephews, their uncles, their mothers. It was wonderful.
Yeah, and I was thrilled to be there because I didn't know how the classes were going, and
That's
I was blown away. So exciting.
Yeah.
Okay, so the way that we can be contacted. So first of all of our classes are up on the Eventbrite platform.
Mm-hmm.
Eventbrite is like an events platform where you can go and reserve or buy tickets. Island House uses it for their theaters. Shakespeare in Paradise uses it for their production, so it's not brand new. And I don't want anyone calling and acting like this brand new. So you go on to Eventbrite. So it's poinsettiapaperpress.eventbrite.com. But also, if you just go to eventbrite.com and you search for Poinsettia Paper Press,
it'll
come up. So all of our classes are there, including Helen's classes, which we just discussed. I have a writing class this Saturday called Writing Your Poetic Memoir, which is just a 4-hour intensive writing class. And then we also have Valentine's Day classes coming up mid-month, which is very exciting.
Are you going to teach these people how to... I mean, I don't need any competition. Don't make them more suave.
That's right. We're going to have that little love notes writing class.
Yes.
There's on actual Valentine's Day, you can come and make a handmade photo album with your partner or yourself. And on the 13th, we have Galentine's Day Sip and Scribe, where you and your gal pal can come and learn some calligraphy with Leanne Key.
The most important part is pal, with your gal pal.
My wife doesn't allow me to have any gal pals.
So
I can't bring no gal pals.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
You can't even bring me. I would hope.
She's stuttering. Gone.
Heavy manners.
Well, then maybe you and your wife can come to the Make Your Own Valentine's Day card class, as
we talked about earlier. Bring sand to the beach.
That's going to be on Sunday the 12th.
Yes.
We even have some classes where you can make some books, matching notebooks for each other ahead of time. So there's lots going on.
Yes, absolutely.
And so the way you can see those classes again are on Eventbrite, poinsettiapaperpress.eventbrite.com. You can also follow us on Instagram and Facebook at Poinsettia Paper Press. And our location, again, is number 12 Parkgate Road. And you can also contact me, Sonia@poinsettiapaperpress.com. That's Sonia, if you want to email me directly.
All right. Mr. Producer, I think it's time to go to a break. Could you play one of those songs by Swain and the Citations? I don't know, guys. I found a new song I had never heard before. It's called Garrett Bounce. Maybe the producer will play that. But since we talk in Galentine's Day, I mean, Swain and the Citations have that song called Sandra. I mean, that's... Sandra. I don't know. Producer, I think you're going to have to play Sandra. That's a Valentine's Day song. I hope so. That's what that is, right?
I listen to the words.
Anyway, listen, you guys, y'all tune in. We go into a break, but listen to this song. Swain and the Citations, among some of the best Bahamian storytellers ever. We'll be right back.
Oh, man, come back home to me. Don't stay by your family. Can't stand the storm and misery. Without you, my life is so hard, night and day and sun. Sandra, honey, but I miss you too bad.
Sandra,
where are you tonight, I wonder?
Sandra,
absence make my heart feel small.
Sandra,
oh, don't leave me no longer to suffer.
J.S. Johnson Insurance Agents are the best. Reliable service, we've been on the scene, protecting since 1919. J.S. Johnson Insurance has the test. Always, you're always covered, baby.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The new Guardian Radio app is here. Listen live to all our Guardian Radio shows and live video stream select programs in our studio. Get information about Guardian Radio shows and our hosts. Send messages, including text, email, and even call. All from our amazing new Guardian Radio app. Download it free today in your App Store for your Apple device or Play Store for your Android device. The all-new and improved Guardian Radio app.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Sandra, darling, why did you have to go?
Sandra,
where are you tonight, I wonder?
Good morning and welcome back to the On The Clock Guardian Radio AM Man Down Mashup Wednesday session. Joining me, Ian Munnings and Cecil Newry. Boy, Cecil Newry, I's the secretary again today. You see that, eh?
I'm not wanting to change the subject. Yeah. I appreciate the song that you play today. Mm-hmm. Because all my life, I always thought Sandra was a male. And I always assumed that it was a story about a male. And now I'm listening to it. It's about a female.
Yeah. And about love.
And about love.
And listen, I just need you all. I'm glad I played the song too. I just wanted something upbeat, you know, and then I realized it is a Bohemian love song.
It's a ballad. It's a ballad.
Yeah, you tell me, come back. I can't. And then I have to say this, ladies. I don't know if Bohemian men need any more help. I don't know if they need any more help.
You're being trapped.
They're doing a very good job.
Leave us men alone. I'm watching you.
They're creative.
I'm watching you. You are trying to have it make sure to be disadvantaged. No. Shh.
Y'all don't need the help.
I don't want you to help us.
Such beautiful storytellers.
Leave us alone.
Oh, yeah. Such no, I'm not stealing the tree and the fruit, ma'am.
I see.
This is an initiative, a community initiative, mm-hmm. and you and I. That's what the gentleman told my grandmother. Mm-hmm. She met the young man in the pear tree. She knew him. She knew of him. She knew what to expect when she heard him in the tree. So she said, "Peter." He said, "Yes, ma'am. I'm going to go sell these right now and bring you back your money." Y'all, Bohemian men are the most beautiful storytellers in the world. And I don't know if they need any. Us ladies, we need some help. We need some help.
I listen to you. I just saying, I'm watching you.
But most importantly, I think with that, we have this awesome power.
Mm-hmm.
Like in every space in the Bahamas, there's talent galore.
Yes.
Sort of what's missing is the systems to help people. Yeah, maximize, use, right?
Absolutely.
And sometimes not even for good, for their own purposes. Mm. Like we have this talent, we're talking about writing the essay and that the essay is for someone else, right? And so I love the press, Ponciana Paper Press, and I love creating a space to enable people, to allow people to see their potential and to tell the stories that will change, if not the whole world, their own world, right? Crafting wonder and writing the fantastic.
Absolutely.
Connecting to ourselves and seeing our own selves as real because we also have the tools that other cultures have used to forge their identities. Mm-hmm. The Chikchani is real.
Mm-hmm.
The Mer-King and the Mer-Queen are real.
Mm-hmm.
The Yahoo, I don't know about the Yahoo, right?
Yeah.
But the Jack-o'-lantern from Long Island, right? So the Chikchani is sort of a northern...
So the Jack-o'-lantern, they used to steal goats or stuff like that?
You know they're from Long Island, but they steal goats. So it's like the Jack-o'-lantern is the Long Island version of the Chikchani.
Mm.
And the tale was... don't go out late at night and don't know where you're going. Don't go out alone. Don't go out on a trip you've never made before, because the jack-o'-lantern, right? Jack-o'-lantern is a light, right? Will put up false lights to trick you into going in the wrong direction. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And that's their version. Cecil, yeah, man.
No, I'm just saying you have 1 minute.
But listen, you let these ladies spin a story, they'll create a whole new Bahamas.
Yeah, yeah.
Your last words, ladies?
Erin, I just want to thank you again for having us on this morning to talk about Poinciana Paper Press and especially our upcoming classes, including, of course, Helen Clinaris's Writing the Fantastic and Crafting Wonder, which all start in February. So if you can't wait, I have a writing class starting this Saturday, Writing Your Poetic Memoir. But we also have many, many classes coming up in February. Silkscreen Printing with Margot Bethel. We have Make Your Own Valentine's Day. So that's on the 4th, by the way, February 4th. Mm-hmm. Make Your Own Valentine's Day cards on the 12th. Make a photo album on actual Valentine's Day on the 14th. Galentine's Day Sip and Scribe with your gal pals on the 13th. Writing Love Notes with May Ford on the 16th. So there's a lot going on. And also, I didn't even mention our book club, which starts this month. So it's starting tomorrow. It's Feminist Book Club, which we are in collaboration with Equality Bahamas. Alicia Wallace and I started it off. So
Feminish.
Ooh, maybe we should change it. Feminish Book Club. Yes. Yes, you don't have to be a feminist or identify as a woman to join.
You could come. That's why it's feminish. You could come.
Yes.
You shouldn't be there. You should not be there.
We are reading Jamaica Kincaid's A Small Place.
Oh, nice.
Month.
Nice.
So we're talking about that tomorrow, but people can join anytime. Next month is What My Bones Know, a memoir of healing from complex trauma by Stephanie Fu, which is a brilliant book.
Is there a charge to join
that? No, it is free. To join the book club.
Free.
I mean, you got to purchase your book, but you could also read the copy we have in our library for free. You have to stay there and read it, though. I don't do checking out. I ain't trusting like that.
Absolutely. See?
So check out our classes. They're on Eventbrite, poincianapaperpress.eventbrite.com. And also follow us on Instagram and Facebook at Poinciana Paper Press. You can also pass by and visit us. We have not too solid hours, but we're at number 12 Parkgate Road.
Absolutely. And I'll be sharing these details over the coming weeks.
Thank you.
Because it's a lot of stuff to do.
Yes.
And I love it. Things to do for lovers.
Yes.
We say that relationships are sacred and important, but do we show it by providing opportunities for them to build and hold their love together? Producer, play that song, Garrett Bounce or Sandra or something. Even you guys could imagine I found a version of Penny Sausage by Exuma Tony McKay. Amazing.
We can bring it in on the next act.
Absolutely. Let it go, producer. We are off the clock. Well, we're off the clock because now we're sliding into the Guardian Radio AM Man Down Mashup Wednesday session, and we're talking about migration and all things hot news. Thanks for tuning into this session. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
You can't make the world go round. You don't know what's going on. Yeah, yeah, today and tomorrow you're gone. When the holy cow is milking and the greenbacks are rolling, you are king and queen in. But when the greenbacks turn brown and you fall down, what you gonna do, baby?
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.